If you're just looking at the United States, stock market excellent, growth and job growth pretty good, wage growth disappointing. If you're grading on a curve, you'd look at what's happening in the rest of the world and you'd see that US growth is actually upgraded less than growth in Europe, growth in Japan. Stock markets in those countries measured in dollars have outperformed the stock market in the United States. So we're participating in a global rally. It's a great global rally, but I'm not going to look for the seeds of it right here in the United States.
You know, you're right if you look over the last year. But if you look back to what happened from the election day, the gains are more significant in the United States because the gains did start the day after President Trump was elected.
If you do it from election day, yeah. The S&P is up 30%. The MSCI EAFE, which is Advanced Economies Outside of North America, is up 33%. So they still beat us, the rest of the world, by 3 points since election day. Measure it in dollars, and that difference grows a bit more. But again, this is a global rally, and it's a great thing. It's an exciting thing.
So how would you break down? You said, again, if you look at the stock market, great. If you look at the economy, great. But if you look at wage gains, that's your biggest concern. What do you think is happening there?
Yeah, last 12 months, real wages are up 0.4.
Which is surprising, given everything we've seen and people thinking, okay, inflation is going to come at some point.
Right.
We'll see wage growth.
In the previous 4 years, real wages were up at a 1.1% annual rate. So you've actually seen a slowdown. That's because even with labor markets tightening, that nominal wage growth is still just not picking up in the way it is. Maybe that means we need to drive the unemployment rate even lower. It's fallen 0.6% in the past year. Maybe it could fall another 0.6% over the next year. I think that might be an experiment worth trying.
Sam Zell was here yesterday. He said he thinks it's because you have not seen productivity gains, and that ultimately, without productivity gains, you are not going to see wage growth. What do you say to that?
I think that's a big part of it. And that's, you know, if you look at the growth we've had in the last year, a lot of it's come from employment. Not enough of it has come from productivity. We're going to need a big pickup in productivity to have sustained economic growth in the future. I think that could happen. There's a lot of really exciting innovation. We need to figure out how to harness it in the economy.
What's wrong with productivity and what has been wrong for a while? Because there's so many different people who say different answers, from it's not being measured correctly to we've just changed fundamentally and we can't do it anymore. What do you
think? Yeah, I think we've never measured it correctly, but I don't think the measurement issue has changed a lot over time, so I wouldn't pay much attention to that. I think about half the problem is businesses are not investing enough. Investment has picked up.
I was going to say, the latest numbers we've seen, that has been the bigger move.
But half of that investment pickup has been in one category, which is oil and gas structures. Oil prices are up 40%. Of course, that's up. So the rest of investment just isn't up in the same type of way. The other half is more pure innovation, total factor productivity growth. And I think that's because a lot of our innovation has been concentrated in the very narrow part of the economy. And you've had some reduction in the fluidity and dynamism of the economy, the birth of new businesses,
birth of new babies.
For a long time. Birth of new babies, that's been a problem too.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.